And Sachin, you know, you must be relieved finally that polling is over and that hectic campaign that you've been so busy with is over. The only thing that is actually consistent in these exit polls is Rajasthan, with the exception of one poll that gives the BJP an edge. All exit polls are showing the Congress winning, though some not with perhaps the kind of margin that I'm sure you're hoping would be there for you all. Sachin.
The best thing for us to do is wait for the 11th. But yes, the indications, because of my travels in the state in the last few months, I can tell you that the mood was very palpable in terms of being against the BJP, and also they were very willing and happy to accept the roadmap that the Congress party was putting forth. So it's not just a negative vote, it's also what we are bringing to the table. So I'm confident that when the results come out, you will get a much larger number than what some of the polls are indicating. But more than that, I think there is a sense of accountability. The people are wanting answers to the questions which people have avoided for the last 4 or 5 years. You know, price rise, farmers' distress, unemployment, the economy almost collapsing. So it's very easy to see that across these states, 3 or 4 states where elections are happening, the BJP is in a back foot and the Congress party is giving an alternative form of government which most people are endorsing. And that's really the takeaway for us in these 4 or 5 elections.
We've also seen, Sachin, at least in the last couple of weeks, a strong buzz coming from Rajasthan that the BJP, in fact, which started off very badly in the state, in a sense, you know, caught up, and that Vasundhara was making a comeback, that the gap between the Congress and the BJP may not be as big as you may think it would have been earlier, that the BJP may even spring a surprise. You know, there was also criticism that maybe the Congress didn't do so well with its ticket distribution. Can you tell us your thoughts on that?
So I think let's take a second and see where we started. The Congress party got 21 seats out of 200 last time, and BJP got 165. The difference was 140 seats. That's where we started from. And the fact that most of you, at least some of you, are conceding that the Congress was doing well all throughout the 4 years. And I can tell you, when the final numbers come out, this last-minute propaganda and spending of money and ads and television and social media does not really change the popular mood. Because for 4 years, 11 months and 25 days, people suffered. And last minute, whether Mr. Amit Shah or the Prime Minister or Yogi Adityanath ji come and give some speeches will change the people's mood. I think it's a really propaganda-driven strategy just to make sure that, you know, they can salvage some dignity in this defeat. The writing was on the wall. They lost every election, from Sarpanch to Pradhan to municipalities to assembly by-elections to parliament by-elections. The party leaders and party workers worked really hard for 5 years. And I must give credit to every single Congress person who has worked tirelessly to bring the party where it is today. And also due credit to all the leaders in the state. If we had not worked as a team, we would not be as strong as we are today. In terms of the ticket distribution, yes, there were more claimants than we had liked for in each constituency, but it's par for the course. Ultimately, it's a bipolar polity. People are voting for the party, for our manifesto, for our ideology, and for our roadmap ahead. Individuals matter, but not as much. So the party really is the pivotal to how people decide which party they will choose. And the party, Congress party, I think, has really etched itself in the hearts and minds of people of Rajasthan.
There's also been a lot of reportage, Sachin, from both Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, which seems to suggest that while there may be a very strong anti-incumbency against Vasundhara Raje, that there may not be that kind of deep-seated anger against Mr. Modi himself. And that could, you know, play out very interestingly in the Lok Sabha election, that actually Mr. Modi is not as popular in Madhya Pradesh, maybe, but he's actually still well-liked in Rajasthan. Again, how do you look at that politically? Because you're just months away from a Lok Sabha poll.
So these two by-elections in Rajasthan, Alwar and Ajmer, they were not elections to the assembly, they were elections to the parliament. The two by-elections in Uttar Pradesh where BJP lost. So every single Lok Sabha by-election the BJP is losing, it's an election to the Indian parliament, not to state assembly. And I think Mr. Modi and the BJP can't distance themselves from a poor performance in a state. But ultimately, Vasundhara ji is a BJP CM and they have to be accountable for her performance. You can't give her applause when she gets 165 seats and then say, well, you know, that's her problem that she lost. BJP is ultimately a party that's responsible. Both the PM and the CM come from the same party. So I don't think it's that easy, because the GST, the demonetization, it's all affecting the common man's life every day. And it's not so, it's not so binary and black and white that this is central, this is state. They're both BJP. If BJP takes pride in saying how many states we have a government, then they must also then face the flag of all the three or four states that have just gone to polls. And to my mind, this whole strategy of distancing the Delhi leadership of BJP from the local leadership according to what suits them will not cut any more ice.
Well, quick last question, Sachin, the one that you're sick of answering, but I will ask you anyway. If you do go on to win this election, as the exit polls predict, are we going to see you as chief minister possibly?
And I don't know. My job 5 years ago was to come and rebuild this party, and we've done this with the support of all our leaders in the state. And I really think I'm a very fortunate party president to have got so much cooperation and support from all leaders in Rajasthan. Let's wait for 11th. The party is very clearly mandated that once we win the majority, we all sit down together and figure out who will head the government. This has been the party policy for the last 70 years. So there's nothing new. There's no novelty in your question. This is just something we do every time in every state, barring one or two exceptions. Right now, I just want to have a nice bath and go to sleep and get at least 8-9 hours sleep tonight.
I think you deserve that. Thanks a lot, Sachin Pilot, for speaking to us. Good luck for the 11th of December.